Okay, hopefully that was enough time for the pre-roll ads, and my captions aren't working. Oh boy. Should it- whoa, hello, okay. These ones aren't, okay, just a second. Oh, come on. Oh, that's a bit better. Down you go. Okay, so for... oh, okay, that's weird. For some reason, my... oh, okay, now the other ones are working. It wouldn't be a Twitch stream without something going wrong right at the start, would it? Alright, so, welcome back to Super Robot Wars 30. Let's just jump right into the endgame because I already spent all my money. Okay, right to What Follows Myth, which is the only story mission we've got left. Which means that we are at... let's see, What Follows Myth. Okay, so I want to try and do at least this stage and the two after it today. They'll probably be quite big. So this one, I just need Katagina to get shot down. Yeah, that's because it's literally magical. And of course I get one of you useless fuckers. Just a moment. Chat messages, spam, scramble bots. That's the very first thing that happens after I finally manage to find time to stream again is a bot shows up on stream like right away. Okay, well, I wasn't using either of them, so that's fine. We just bring all the real robot units. Which I'm starting to run out of room for. Okay, so let's have a look at this thing. Hello, Ludwig. Oh, okay, so now it's just literally the unicorn. Very cool. So this one works best on the ground. Oh, this one works on the ground and in space, but doesn't fly. And it doesn't have any abilities. Okay, cool. I assume that's going to get fixed. Okay, yes, that gets fixed on this map, but it's kind of silly that it doesn't even have, like, a psycho frame ability or anything. Thank you, Ludwig. Oh, is the Ikaruga still... Yeah. It still doesn't have its upgrade like it should. I think I'd get that maybe in a few missions' time. Wait, shouldn't that have activated? Oh, it activates at 120 morale because of his ace bonus, doesn't it? But do I not have that? Oh, I don't even have that. Okay. Really, Sean? No comment? You're not fighting Zeon? Like, at all? Tried. Oh, I probably shouldn't have deployed you. That's all right. We'll manage. Oops. and he, even though I haven't been using him that much, shouldn't really have any issues holding his own. This level just starts going up in, like, you know, two levels at a time. I think this is probably the best use of it. I don't know if I hit the wave you. Hey, Lauren. Not yet. Okay. Did we get a map attack out of this? No, that would be too easy. Okay. Actually, that's probably worth doing so other people can get some kills in. It means that some of the characters that I deployed who I probably shouldn't have can sneak in some kills. Support defender. I forgot that like all of these guys have support defender.
Oh. ずい。まともに食らった。受けた恨みは忘れない。叩き潰す。
お粗末もいいとこね。Okay, I was wondering what was up with this thing's animations, but I've worked out that the shape of the head causes it to look like it's always looking down, and it was really bothering me. Oh, those ones don't have shields, interesting. Just a moment. Can you get a kill with this? Nope. Oh, I just realized why there are helium 3 containers everywhere. We're gonna actually do the like incredibly shitty climax from the narrative books or manga or whatever the fuck it is. Did I remember to cast Resolve? No, I totally didn't. Okay. That might have been a little bit of overkill.
Hmm.
Rip. Oh, it's totally legal to just shoot down the Jiggins. Okay. So I'm just gonna rip straight through them, basically, and the unicorn still only had, the phoenix still only has one attack. Is anyone even going to comment on it? Oh, okay, we're going to do the, what was the one thing? Ludwig, would you get off the microphone cable? Thank you. Yep, definitely didn't hit the cockpit. These things are very high level, which is actually convenient, because my guys are getting good experience off them. Yeah, like, Suzak just gained 3 levels. There's, yeah, these guys are level 45. My concern at this point isn't so much if I'm going to be, like, softlocked, but if I will actually be able to clear the game, just because my units are well behind where we're really supposed to be. Let's see, the fight isn't all the way done yet, so I'm going to... Actually, no, let's cast Disrupt now. I can get two like this, and then I can back off to the Leanhorse Jr. Is what I thought, but of course it used all the energy. So if we finish these guys off, that should be set for morale. Now it's just the boss that I have to fight. Definitely didn't hit the cockpit. At least that's much cheaper now, which is good. He's probably fine. Yeah. Okay, there's armor up speed. I see, we have a Mega Beam Cannon and a Mega Beam Rifle, and they're not the same. Okay, cool. Alright, that makes it your turn. What have you got? It's so goofy. Okay. Okay, but no defensive ability beyond the pilot evasion boost. Oh, cool. Okay, that's gonna suck. He's not otherwise overly threatening. Oh, shit. I need to do something just while the animation's playing. Oh, okay, that hurt. Who has support defend? I literally can't check. Yeah, here we go. I have nothing to say because this whole sequence is just unbelievably fucking stupid. It's more acceptable here than in, like, the actual book that it's from. I guess the author watches 80 Gundam between writing Unicorn and writing Narrative, since they're now like ripping off 80 Gundam wholesale, except like ridiculously stupidly. This animation is nice. Oh, but the silver bullet suppressor still sucks. Okay. Okay, there we go. I meant to do that before I started streaming and it totally slipped my mind. Okay, let's actually have a look at this thing. Oh wait, why am I even doing this? I don't get to keep this. Do I? I do! Okay. That's kind of wild. Okay, I need to knock over Katagina. Let's do that first. Wow, it's actually terrible. This whole unit is so fucking stupid. So like, rather than doing something intelligent, like, you know, using the subarm to create like a mount for the beam magnum, which is oversized for the unit, no, we just have a backpack full of arms, and then we discard the arm when the Rokuhil destroys it and plug in a new arm. I fucking hate Unicorn. It's certainly funny, but it's like, it's so stupid. And like, you know, if it was like 1 year War Zeon, then I would allow it, but... Yo, well, the thing is that... Hold on, I gotta look this up, because I want to be right about this. Okay, so it was remodeled by, like, not a real organization, but seriously? Like, you have a subarm. You could have just put the rifle on the subarm and bolted up instead of carrying a backpack full of arms. It's such a stupid workaround. Like, everything that went into making this, you could have done so much better. But it's like, oh no, we have to preserve that, like, the Beam Magnum is, like, the ultimate weapon because it's passed down from the Unicorn. And as we all know, you know, the Unicorn can, you know, fight Turn A equally and create new universes and will not die in lava. Like, it's really stupid. Yes, but I mean, with all of the things that they used to build, like, the backpack full of arms for the suppressor, they could have just built a cannon mount and mounted the Magnum. It would have been fine. But, like, what I'm saying is they wanted to... The author wanted to preserve that, oh, the Unicorn is so special and powerful. Like, you know, normal units can't even use its weapon. It's like, you are full of shit. Yes, so is the author, so no surprise there. I guess maybe not much of an idiot, considering that they managed to get repeatedly hired to do, like, wildly popular novels or something that they have never read or shown any, like, or demonstrated any knowledge of, which is kind of impressive. So, like, you know, they did a good job of scamming Sunrise. Oh no, I'm sorry, they read CCA and... I actually forgot that. Although which might be because the only thing that has referenced it in the last 20 years is like one wiki page and like one episode of Build Fighters Try. I don't actually know anything about that beyond, the, like, Black Doll meme, which was pretty funny. Well, they certainly fucking tried to make things that were better than Turn A. And it's completely out of place. Yeah, but the thing is, like, if they were going to write for UC, they should have familiarized themselves with UC, but they didn't. They just chose to, like, write complete bullshit. No, I mean, as in, they tried to make Unicorn stronger than Turn A. Just like 00 tried to make 00 stronger than Turn A. Because that's, like, apparently what you have to do is, oh, it has to be able to, you know, beat Turn A and... Whatever. It's really shit. the absolute state of Gundam writing. Given that they just, like, wholesale ripped off the end of Zeta Gundam, and I mean, like, not even, like, in general terms, like, beat for beat identical to Zeta Gundam, I think it's fair to say they watched that and really liked it. But only between Unicorn and Narrative. Oh yeah, Moon Moon, god, that thing is a fucking abomination. Okay, I was like, what is that backpack? But just the whole thing is literally just a mega launcher. Yeah, maybe. I don't know, in... Actually, I guess they probably would have had to have seen Zeta Gundam since they, like, used Minerva for Unicorn. So I guess they were familiar with that much at least, but yeah, they just distinctly did not give a shit about anything that came after. And not much about what came before. It's like, you know, if you're writing for something like Gundam, it's a huge part of the franchise's identity is that it has this, like, insane legacy. You know, and one work follows through to the next, especially in, like, UC specifically, that's a huge deal.
Chica! ン様が前に出てきちゃ狙われちゃうだろう。避けられるかよ。
ギリギリでも当たらなければどうということはない。
みんなと一緒に戦うんだ。
Like, okay, I've bitched about this before, but I don't remember if I've said this, like, on stream during this playthrough. I'm actually studying, like, writing at university, like a Master's of Writing, which covers, like, both amateur and professional writing. So this is, like, the kind of thing that you specifically train about is, you know, how to come into something that you don't, weren't there for the genesis of, and, like, working your writing into that is a big part of it. So it's actually, like, professionally offensive to me. How shitty Unicorn is. I wonder if he has dialogue for Katarzyna. I'm gonna have to rearrange all of my UC units after this because I think you keep the narrative. Yeah, in fact, it even got a new attack that we didn't get to see. So end up. Ah, there you are. Nice damage, Bozo. Can you get that? You can, okay. And there's no way that you're not gonna kill her, right? What? Okay, fuck it, I'll just feed you to Jonah.
ザンスカールの好きにさせるわけには。作るんだ俺たちの物語を。俺たちの未来を。
Oh yeah, yeah, nice. Very subtle title drop. That wasn't forced at all. See, because the name of the book is narrative. Fuck me, this is terrible. I thought I was in range. Can I pick up from? Nope. Okay, well, rip that turn. You gotta stay out of the way, I think. Otherwise, you're going to turn up dead, and that would be really bad. Tell him, please. You can tell I haven't done enough real robot stages. What is that attack even labeled? Oh, that's just this sucker shot. Whoa! I just noticed its special effect. That's concerning. At least Sultan's dialogue is great. He's actually unhinged. You know, just fighting him will probably level you up, I just realized. No, we've established they're not the sleeves, so I guess they just didn't have more dialogue for that.
ンダムが来たか。このセカンドね。
そんな攻撃当たらない。
やっ。Wow. I had no idea that Zoltan had unique dialogue for the rabbits. Or possibly just Izuru specifically. That's cool. Yeah, let's get Shine, shall we? Okay, since you like Zeta Gundam so much, let's end it in the same way. That was a lot of money. Oh, I see. The Phoenix trying to turn back time. Like, the Phoenix turning back time to undo the Helium 3 explosion with new type magic is what should happen here. But that was apparently too stupid even for Super Robot Wars, so they just had, like, the Neo Zeon being destroyed, like, stop it from hyper-compressing the Helium 3. Oh, I guess the idea is that you would put Banaja in the narrative. Well, the silver bullet suppressor sucks, so... Oh, yeah, that too. No, there's a narrative in Unicorn, it's just about Banaja having no morals and no spine. Not bad, but her passive ability is so freaking terrible. Okay, let's see. Oh, nice. It did inherit all of the, that five. Five, six. So actually what I should do is I should put Camille in, in the Phoenix, because he has the highest new type level, which works well with its upgrade ability. Or I should give it to Banaja, who is quite good as well. Where the narrative end up? Okay, so it's back here. Hold on, let me swap it back to the C-type. Which can be used anywhere without complaining. And now has an actual finishing move. Oh. You can't reassign the Phoenix, okay. Well, I was hopeful that I could give it to a better pilot, but I mean, I did kind of think it was going to be fixed, but it would have been funny to put Camille in it. Like, Camille specifically would have been really funny to put in it. However, the Silver Bullet is still, like, a noticeable step up from units like the V-Dash Gundam. And you're an even better pilot for it. Okay, cool. Yeah, that too. I just need to fix something to do with the audio. So at the moment it's, yeah, it's set to unit, which is sort of correct, but... Suppressor will cost almost nothing to fully upgrade, so I might as well do custom bonus upgrades, so yep, might as well do that. Who else do I have lurking around that I might actually use at some point? There we go. The real thing about Purple 2 is how incredibly good its custom bonus is. Yeah, I know, it's like super good. It's just, the reason it's been languishing until now is because I just haven't had the spare resources to spend on it. Okay, so I should go to the new ending, to the true ending route, and I need to defeat Conqueror King Genesic with a Gargaygar character. Ha! that's a nice touch. This is how Mamoru's parents react to him asking them if he's not really their kid when he finds out that he's adopted. So that's a nice touch. Hang on, I'm going to have a laugh about this with Finn because we were talking about this the other day. Chamaki's literally out here like, oh no, he's hot. Okay, calm down, ass. Yeah, but like it's really funny in this case because she's like, ah. Okay, this didn't go where I thought it was going to. That does explain why I felt like we were the bad guys, though, because Mitsuko was being controlled by one. Okay, I guess we just deploy all the super robots first. And since I have some spare slots, you're never a bad choice, and yeah, I'll just bring you. You have Supreme, like, you can never be bad. The what? Oh, I see. Is it only those ones? Wait, what's the difference between... Oh, you have guns on the bottom. And you don't. Okay. So, yeah, I want to try and get to the back and deal with that quickly. This chain of command is really obnoxious. Because they're getting 10% to hit, and there are 32 enemies on the map. So they're getting plus 320% to hit. So rather than take things slowly, I think trying to break through to the back and take out the 2-bit chain of command is actually the best move. They still can't hit us, though. Oh no, wait, I misread it. It's number of units on the map divided by 5, and that's the percent value. So it's 32 divided by 5 expressed as a percent, which is a lot less than I thought it was. So it's plus 6.4% twice, so okay, it's literally much, much worse than I thought it was. I got spooked because the AI units and OG's Gaiden have like a super version of that, and it's really frustrating.
甲子園の力を見せてやる。くらえ、アイアンガッド。
Can this move on the- okay, it totally can. That's very cursed, but okay. I'm really disappointed that it doesn't look like there's like a Shin Getter Dragon and Shin Dragon combo attack, because that would be really awesome. Oh right, this can't transform for some reason. I really like this animation. It's very accurate to the early parts of the show. Wait, you don't have something dumb like an S in the air, do you? Okay, good. Oh, right. I was about to be like, wait, shouldn't it actually be Stargar Gygar by this point? But, of course, the Stargar Gygar two parts were destroyed in Final when the fake Mamoru sold them and fought with Guy. You definitely don't need to do that, dude. You could just do this. No, you can't just do that. Okay, got this. Surely that should be enough, even though it doesn't say so. Oh. Okay, nice crit. Ludwig, it's okay, buddy. It's just me tapping my foot. Whoever provides that voice sounds really familiar. Tetsuya having charge is such a waste of a slot, since all but two of his attacks are post-movement. And one of them is a combo attack. Wait, hold on. Shouldn't you guys be on the Tristrega? Because that's where Junk is? I guess they did say that everyone would stand by on the other units, but still. You can't just, like, move Junk that easily. That reminds me, I need to see if anyone's uploaded the, I need to get a totally legitimate copy of the Gridman Dino Zenon movie. Oops, I thought they had enough movement for that, and they did not. Can't get there. But I can make this guy really unhappy.
私は人工知能ってやつが苦手だったけどね。一気に決める。ヘル&ヘデン。
Hit and run for you, or am I done? I'm done. Okay, cool. Yes.Right? I was actually chatting with Finn about it the other day because she showed it to a friend and I joked, okay, obviously your friend is an epileptic. We noticed that, first of all, it feels like it's actually worse on the Blu-ray because of the, like, much higher quality and the higher bitrate of the rips. And second, I was like, I wonder if I could, like, you know, use, like, a deep learning AI or something to, like, automatically remove strobing from videos. Like, even by just cloning the offending frame while keeping the audio running, it would be, like, watchable. The quality would go down, but... Oh, it's definitely possible. It's just, like, I don't know how to do it. You are asking the wrong people that question. Yeah. I had to try and remember what that did for a second there. I mean, if anyone wanted to do it, then, like, Galgaia is the perfect training ground for it. Okay, I dead ass don't even know what that word means, and that's pretty rare. Mob rule, government by the masses, mobocracy, but it's like super ancient. It's from like literally the 1400s. Actually, I don't know if I linked it when I was watching it, but at one point you actually see the King Jada and Gargaga in the same shot, and Gargaga is like literally the size of King Jada's head, because King Jada is that huge. Okay, I'll find the image because it really cracked me up. Does one of you have support attack? Yes, okay. Just gained a casual 6 levels. Wait, hold on. I can actually make use of your map attack. If it says friendly fire control on, does that mean it's going to hit them? Okay, yes, it does. So you two need to get out of the way. Wait, hold on, what do you have that's stronger than hell? Oh, right, double hammer, yeah, I forgot about this, because it's so freaking goofy. Okay, that didn't go as well as I hoped it would. I was hoping for a critical. Okay, I see we didn't sanity check this and just copy-pasted lines. I am really disappointed that, like, for the climactic showdown, it just shows up with, like, 8 Zondarobos and that's it. Really? Oh, we're topped out without spending any SP, nice. Oh, but it's flying, so it doesn't get the benefit. What an idiot. You just stand on the tile, but don't get any benefits from it. Have to remember to buy Hit and Away for Jay Decker. Oh, this is post movement now, right?
Thank you.
Okay, I might just spend a turn getting everyone into position before we actually do this fight. Or it might actually be a couple of turns. Oh, he moved? Okay. Calm down, Dracula. Maybe I won't wait. I guess scums, that's definitely a word that is a plural in English. That has a lot of HP. Immobile? Dude, why is its Hell and Heaven animated so much better than ours? Okay, so that one does morale down and this one just does immobile, okay. Does that prevent... Yeah, it does. Okay, very cool.
けでこの俺に勝てると思うなよ。グレートブースター射出。ドッキング完了。くらえ、グレートブースター私の考えていることなどお見通しだ。
I'm really glad that I took all of the super robots.I can finally fix Spider-Man Cataphract's theme. It doesn't fly. Hit by that. Do you have a disable or anything? No. Oh right, it can only do Orthover Omega emission from that far. I was scared about hell and heaven when I didn't need to be. How much HP are you actually? 200,000, okay. Is that close enough to call you? Yeah, that's so it's going to get back 60,000 HP every turn. 66,000 rather. His HP regen large is 30%, right? Yeah.
ぶった切ってやるか。勝負だ。 スだったのにな。
Man, it sure would be nice if I could use those, like, at literally any other time. Also, Az looks hilarious in that cockpit shot. She's so tiny that she's, like, reaching all the way out with both hands. Rather, it's inside my minimum range.
による被弾箇所なし。
それは何よりです。
その力我が身をもって知っているが、ここで引くわけにはいかん。俺が目指す、俺が本命だ。
Yeah, I don't think I'm going to actually melee with that.
Oh,
I should have switched pilots. Kaido has better attacking stats. Also, wow, that's not great. Yeah, I couldn't quite get him. That's frustrating. He's gonna get back so much HP. That's really frustrating. Okay, what do you have to do? 1, 2, 3.
究その道を開く。
That cut in though. I need to set Analyze again as well. I totally forgot. Okay, there's no way Az does 15k on a support attack. Seriously, she has to lean so far forward to grab the sticks.
Ha
Just going to take a quick save there in case things go badly. Look at that money. Okay, I think I'll make that the last one for today, or at least for now, because I gotta stop for dinner shortly, and that took forever. F. B. Okay, I see that we just, like, stopped actually quality controlling by this point, because they probably figured correctly that most people would never get this far. I'm not going to do another one either today or right now, but probably today, and I'll try and come back sooner next time. But that fight took forever because I wanted to see all the unique dialogue with Gogorking Genesic. Okay, so see you sooner next time, hopefully. Things have been much more of a mess than I expected them to be after I signed off last time, but here we go. So I'll see everyone next time.